What we want to look at here is an unsteady state mass balance, or an ink in a tank example. What this is that water enters and leaves a 5 cubic meter tank at a rate of 0.12 cubic meters per minute. At time t is equal to 0, 1 kilogram of ink is injected into the tank. We are going to assume that the ink is well mixed and evenly distributed. And the question then is, complete the mass balance. So what I want to do quickly is let's just draw the system. So what we've got is a tank, which has water in it, and that water is entering and exiting this tank, this well-mixed tank, at a rate of 0.12 cubic meters per minute. And that is also what is coming in, so 0.12 cubic meters per minute. And the question now is, complete the mass balance. So where we're going to start is with the mass balance of the water. For any mass balance, we're going to start with dm dt is equal to the sum for mass I, for I is equal to 1 to n. For this one, we said the water is coming in and out at the same rate. So it's going to mean that this is at steady state, the water. So just as a reminder, we're looking currently at the water in this tank. So that means that we've got 0, the steady state term, is equal to mass that's coming in, so that is a positive, and there's a negative because there's a mass coming out. So simply speaking, for the water, we have mass in is equal to mass out, and in the question it already said that this was at a rate of 0.12 cubic meters per minute. We now want to look at what is the mass balance for the ink. So they've given us some additional information about the ink. So what they've said is that at time is equal to 0, 1 kilogram of ink is injected into this tank. So what that is that at time 0, we're going to say that 1 kilogram of ink is injected into this tank. So we're going to say that is at time 0, so it is simply a 1, 2, 3, it is all in. We've also said that this is well mixed, so any ink that comes into this tank, the concentration of this ink in this tank is going to be equal throughout, which also means that this concentration of ink coming out with the water is going to be equal at any given time. This problem now, though, is not steady state. So at time is equal to 0, ink comes in. Any time after that, no ink is coming in, but we have got ink coming out, and that concentration is going to not change because of the water that's coming in and effectively diluting this ink as we go through. So what is that mass balance? We are again going to start, so let's just write this now, this is the ink. We're again going to start with a mass balance. dm dt is equal to the sum for mi, for I is equal to 1 to n, the mass balance, the general mass balance equation. We've already said that this is not going to be at steady state. So dm dt term has to stay in. What goes in? We said nothing goes in, so we're going to assume that 1, 2, 3, everything is in this tank, so nothing new is going in this tank. But we do have a mass flow out, going out of this tank with the water stream. So we're left with dm dt is equal to 0 minus m out. However, we've been given additional information. So let's just have a look here quickly. We've been told that this is a 5 cubic meter tank. So it's a 5 cubic meter tank. We know the volume of the tank. We also know the mass of ink that goes in. So we know a concentration of the ink in this tank at time 0. So if we know the concentration, we now want to look at the mass balance and change this mass into a concentration. Mass is equal to, let's just write it, mass is equal to concentration times the volume. So we can change dm dt to change in concentration times volume, divided by dt is equal to, on the right hand side, minus the mass flow rate out. In the same way, we can also write that mass out as a negative, to leave the negative term there for the mass out, velocity out multiplied by the concentration out. What we now have as a dt term, On the left-hand side, we have a concentration, and on the right-hand side, we have a concentration. So this is going to be a separable differential equation where we need to take all the same terms onto the left-hand onto the same side. So we'll bring the C onto the left-hand side, and we'll take the dT onto the right-hand side. Okay. Before we do that, let's just note that the volume is constant. So we could have the volume outside. So we'll have volume multiplied by dC. We now bring the concentration from the right-hand side onto the left-hand side. So it's dC divided by the concentration out is equal to the minus velocity, which will stay on the right-hand side. And we now take the dT onto the right-hand side. From this, we're now just going to do maths for now. So we should know that we want to integrate. So we're going to have velocity dC. The velocity is a constant, so we will leave that outside the integral and have 1 on concentration on the left-hand side equal to a minus velocity out, that's also a constant, integral dt. The concentration is a 1 on concentration. So if we have a 1 on concentration, the integral of that is going to be a ln. So it will be the velocity, sorry, not the velocity, the volume multiplied by the natural log of 1 on C, so it's going to be the concentration out divided by the initial concentration out on the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, the velocity out is the constant which stays there. The integral of dt is simply t minus the initial t, ti. So there we have our equation with variables. We have, however, got some information from our question. So we had, there's a 5 cubic meter tank, 0.12 cubic meters per minute, time 0 to 1 kilogram. So we've got some information here. So we can put this into our equation now. So we do know that at I, that's the initial time. So at point I, that is where Ti, the initial time, is equal to 0. We also know that the concentration, which is the initial concentration, is when the ink first enters the tank, is going to be 1 kilogram of ink entering into this tank divided by 5 cubic meters. So this equals to 0.2 kilograms per cubic meter. What we now want to do is to put this information into the equation at the top of the screen. So we have the velocity, which is 5, sorry, not the velocity, the volume, which is 5 cubic meters, multiplied by the natural log of the concentration out, so we still don't know what that concentration is, divided by the initial concentration. Let's just move this a little bit down. The initial concentration, which was 0.2, so that's 0.2, is equal to, let's just go back up to remind me more than anybody else, there's our equation. It's going to be minus V out. So that minus V out we said was minus, to keep the minus there, 0.12 cubic meters per minute, multiplied by the T minus T out. The T is the unknown time. T initial is naught. So now we simply need to simplify this. So we're going to have the ln of the concentration out divided by 0.2. is equal to minus 0.12. I'm going to divide by 5. So that is this 5 here that's coming onto the right-hand side. So we'll divide that by 5. Multiplied by t. T minus 0 is simply t. We now want to take this ln of 0.2. So it's actually a 1 on 0.2 out of this ln times c out. So we're going to have the ln of the concentration out minus a ln of 0.2. So taking the ln of 1 over becomes a minus ln 0.2 on the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, this will then be equal to a negative 0.024t. So I'm dividing, I'm taking 0.12 divided by 5 to get that 0.024 value. The left-hand side, we will leave the ln of C out, and we'll take the negative 0.2 to the right. So we'll be left with minus 0.024t, as was originally there, plus the natural log of 0.2. To get the final concentration, we want the concentration out. We're going to take the entire right-hand side and we're going to raise that to the power of E. So on the right-hand side, we'll have the concentration, sorry, the E to the power of ln 0.2 minus 0.024 times by T. So that whole term is that, and that will be the final answer for this mass balance problem.